ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
మాక్స్వెల్ బోల్ట్జ్మాన్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ మాలిక్యులర్ స్పీడ్స్. టు అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ సమ్ కంటైనర్. లెట్ అస్ టేక్ సమ్ కంటైనర్. ఇమాజిన్ సమ్ గ్యాస్ ఇన్ దిస్ కంటైనర్. Gas molecules in the container. The velocity of gas molecule changes continuously. The energy of gas molecule changes continuously. So why it changes continuously? If I take these gas molecules, in the last class we have studied that they possess certain kinetic energy. They are in constant continuous movement. In this process they collide with each other, with the walls of the container. Because of these collisions, energy is transferred between the molecules. Some molecules gain energy, some molecules lose energy. Because of which, the energy of the molecule and velocity of the molecule changes continuously. Therefore, it is not possible to determine the velocity exact or absolute velocity of each and every gas molecule. I repeat, the velocity of gas molecule changes continuously because of collisions. It is not possible to determine the exact velocity value for each and every gas molecule. So we express the velocity of gas molecules as average velocity. We express the velocity as average velocity as a whole, correct? So because of collisions, it results in change in the velocity, redistribution of energies of gas molecules. This is explained by Maxwell and Boltzmann, correct? So what they have done, they have studied, and from based upon their studies we will try to understand some graphs. Graph is plotted between number of gas molecules versus speed. Number of gas molecules versus speed. So the graph looks like this. You'll get a curve like this, right? So here if I move from this point to this point in this direction, the velocity of gas molecules increases. If I move from this point to this point, that means along y-axis, number of molecules increases. First point, the area under the curve, this area represents what? The area under the curve equates total number of gas molecules. The area under this curve equates, right, or represents or equals to total number of gas molecules. More the gas molecules, more area you will get. So the area under the curve equates total number of gas molecules. That is the first point. The second point is the fraction of molecules having, this is zero velocity or very less velocity, the fraction of molecules, this is the fraction having zero velocity, this area, zero velocity, the fraction of molecules having very high velocity. If I move from this point to this point, velocity increases. The fraction, this is the, you have to just join, extend, project it on the y-axis, this fraction. So this fraction has this much of high velocity. So the fraction of molecules, that is this point, fraction of molecules you'll get on the y-axis. The speed value will get on the x-axis. The fraction of molecules having zero velocity and the fraction of molecules having very high velocity is very small. So the number of molecules having zero velocity, that means which do not move, which are at rest, are very, very less. And the fraction, the number of molecules having very high speed is also very less. So if I move from this zero velocity in this direction, so this is the fraction of molecules having this particular velocity, say u1. If I draw another line like this, u2 velocity, this is the fraction of molecules having u2 velocity. So if I compare u1 and u2, u2 is greater than u1. So as I move in this direction, the number of molecules having high velocity keep on increases till it reaches the maximum value. The peak of the curve is nothing but maximum. After reaching a maximum, again it decreases. Again it decreases. So what is happening here? Number of molecules having high velocity increases, reaches a maximum value, thereafter again it decreases. The peak of the curve, this peak of the curve represents a fraction which has this particular velocity. So this is the maximum fraction of total molecules that can have this velocity. This velocity we call it as most probable velocity. The peak of the curve represents most probable velocity. It is velocity possessed by maximum fraction of total gas molecules. So this is the velocity possessed by more number of gas molecules. That velocity we call it as most probable velocity, and in the graph it can be easily identified by pointing the peak of the curve. So these are the important points. What happens? This is at constant temperature. What happens if you change the temperature? The red one indicates hot gas. I'm taking same gas but at high different temperatures, say T2. The blue one indicates cold gas. With increase in temperature, the graph broadens. First point. With increase in temperature for same gas, the graph broadens. The graph is broadening, becoming wide. The graph is broadening. What is the meaning of broadening? When you increase temperature, more number of molecules can have higher velocity, or number of molecules having more higher velocity keep on increases with increase in temperature. So this is the fraction of molecules. See, its velocity maximum changes. This is the most probable velocity and this is the most probable velocity, right, for hot gas. This is the most probable velocity for hot gas. This is the most probable velocity for cold gas. When you heat it, this fraction, the maximum number, see, the fraction of molecules having the velocity lies between this point and this point mostly. But in this case, in the hot gas, it broadens. Broadens means it occupies more space. That means the speed range is high. So in this case, more number of molecules can have higher velocity, right, at higher temperature. So these are the three important points. One is most probable velocity, what does the area indicates, and what happens when you increase the temperature. So Maxwell and Boltzmann have shown that the change in velocity and redistribution of energy, that is kinetic energy, depends upon two factors. One is temperature and other is molecular weight. We know that lighter gas travels at faster speed than heavier gas. Lighter gas travels at faster speed than heavier gas. So based upon that, So this is for gas 1, m1, m2. M1 is the velocity, most probable velocity is high for gas 1. That means m1 is lighter gas than m2. This is the most probable velocity for gas 1, this is most probable velocity for gas 2, this value is greater than this, right? So lighter gas moves faster than heavier gas. So m2 should be lighter gas, m1 should be heavier gas because its most probable velocity is less. So from these assumptions explained by Maxwell and Boltzmann, we can conclude that we cannot determine the exact velocity of gas molecule because it changes continuously. So what we can do is we can express the velocity of gas as an average value. How can you take this average? In different ways. So there are three different average types of velocities. So we are going to study three different types of average velocities as explained by Maxwell and Boltzmann. So first, types of average velocities. First one is most probable velocity, represented as U subscript MP or C subscript MP. MP means most probable. So how to define this? It is velocity possessed by maximum fraction of or maximum number of total gas molecules. Out of total number of gas molecules, the velocity possessed by more number of gas molecules, we call it as most probable velocity. From Maxwell and Boltzmann equation, so most probable velocity is given as 2RT by M. This is the equation. So we don't have the derivation. So square root of 2RT by M, R is universal gas constant, T absolute temperature, M is molecular weight of gas. For 1 mole of gas, PV equal to RT. So PV equal to RT. So in the place of RT, I am writing PV. For 1 mole of gas, V by molecular weight is nothing but density. So 2P by D. So I am writing here PV equal to RT, NRT, because N equal to 1 mole, I am taking. And V by M, nothing but V by mass of 1 mole, mass of gas. Of course, 1 mole we are taking. This is nothing but density. So from this equation, we can write that most probable velocity is directly proportional to square root of T by M. So if I substitute these values and simplify, most probable velocity is equal to square root of TRT by M. Substituting the values in CGS units, 8.314 into 10 power 7 ergs per mole per Kelvin into temperature, that will be given in the problem, by molecular weight. So if you simplify this value, you will get 1.27 into 10 power 4 square root of T by M centimeters per second. The next one is average velocity.
It is represented as UAVG or C bar or CAVG.
AVG represents average velocity. So normal average, it is the average of velocities of all gas molecules.
Say in a sample you have different gas molecules, you have n gas molecules. Some gas molecules are moving with velocity u1, some gas molecules with u2, and so on. Then how to take average velocities? Average of all velocities, u1 plus u2 plus u3.
Some fraction is moving with u1 velocity, some fraction is moving with u2, some fraction is moving with u3, by total number of gas molecules. Or this is one way.
The other way is, if n1 molecules moving with velocity u1, n2 molecules moving with velocity u2, and so on, then the average is taken like this: n1 into u1 plus n2 u2, so on, by total number of gas molecules. From Maxwell and Boltzmann equation, U average is equal to 8RT by pi m.
8 is constant, R is universal gas constant, T is temperature in Kelvin, pi is constant, m is molecular weight of gas. Now instead of RT, what I can write? PV for 1 mole of gas. So what I will get here is 8 PV by pi m. For 1 mole of gas, V by m is density.
8 P by pi d. So from this, what I can write is U average is directly proportional to T by m, because 8 R
and pi are constant. So if you substitute and simplify,
eight point 314 into 10^7 ergs per mole per Kelvin, temperature pi, 3.14 into molecular weight. So this will be around 1.45 into 10^4 square root of T by m centimeters per second. That is a simplified equation.
The other velocity is root mean square velocity.
RMS velocity in shortcut. Represented by CRMS or URMS, sometimes generally C itself.
So how to define? It is defined as square root of mean of squares of velocities of gas molecule.
Square root of mean of squares of gas molecules. Can I write like this?
For this first formula, for second formula,
square root of n1 u1 square, n2 u2 square, so on, by n1 plus n2 plus 1.
So this is for first condition, this equation. For second condition, this is the equation. So from Maxwell and Boltzmann equation,
RMS velocity equal to 3RT by m.
For 1 mole of gas, RT is nothing but PV.
So 3 PV by m. So V by m is nothing but density. So from this equation, what I can write is directly proportional to T by m, because 3 is constant, R is also constant. So let us write the simplified equation. Substituting the R value and simplifying in CGS units, 8.314 10 power 7 so 1.58 into 10 power 4 square root of T by m, temperature, molecular weight of the gas, centimeters per second. Right, so next let us find the ratio. Most probable velocity is to average velocity is to RMS velocity. So most probable velocity 2RT by m, average velocity 8RT by pi m, RMS velocity 3RT by m. So simplifying, what is common in this? RT by m is common. So if I cancel, what I will get? Root 2 is to root 8 by pi is to root 3. So dividing with root 2, root 2 is the smaller value. Root 2 by root 2 is 1, is to 1.128 is to 1.224. So for a given gas, from this it is clear that RMS velocity value is greater than average, greater than most probable velocity. So what I can write here is, for a given gas, because molecular weight must be same, T must be same, because anyway R is constant, T and M are variables. For a given gas, molecular weight will be same. I am taking one particular gas. For a constant temperature, I am fixing the same temperature. So from this, what I can write? RMS value will be greater than average velocity, greater than most probable velocity. So if you plot a graph between number of gas molecules versus velocity, that is speed, the peak of the curve is nothing but most probable velocity. Already we have studied most probable velocity. So average is greater than most probable velocity. So it will be somewhere here. Let us assume this is C average for a given gas. RMS is greater than this. Let us assume this value. Now this is RMS velocity. The peak of the curve is most probable velocity. Next one is average velocity. Next one is RMS velocity. Right. Sometimes they will ask you to find the ratio. So let us find the ratio, most probable versus RMS. So this is nothing but root 2 by root 3. I am writing directly, or 1 by 1.224, right. So if you simplify this, root 2 by root 3, I think you will get 0.816. Or average versus RMS velocity, this is what they will ask. Root 8 by pi is to root 3, or 1.128 by 1.224, you will get around 0.9213. So that is the conversion of one velocity into another.
Take any velocity, already we have proved that whether it is RMS, average or most probable, velocity is found to be directly proportional to square root of T by m, right. So for two gases, for two different gases, say gas 1, gas 2, what I can write? C1 by C2 equal to square root of T1 by m1, T2 by m2. C1 is velocity of gas 1, C2 is velocity of gas 2. T1 is temperature of gas 1, m1 is molecular weight of gas 1. T2 is temperature of gas 2, m2 is molecular weight of gas 2. We can apply conditions. If m1 equal to m2, then C1 by C2 equal to square root of T1 by T1. Or if T1 equal to T2, then C1 by C2 equal to square root of M2 by M1. Or if velocities itself are same, then what we get is T1 by M1 equals to T2 by and C is inversely proportional to square root of molecular weight. That means lighter gas moves with higher velocity than heavier gas. This is the graph for number of molecules versus velocities. So this is m1 represents gas 1, m2 represent gas 2 molecular weights. M1 is molecular weight, m2 is molecular weight of respective gases. So at same temperature, so this is the graph curve for gas 1, this is the curve for gas 2. Now I am finding the most probable velocity, that is nothing but peak of the curve. This is the peak of the corresponding velocity is C1 for gas 1. Peak of the curve, the corresponding velocity, most probable velocity for gas 2 is C2. So from the graph it is clear that C2 is greater than C1. Now we know that C is inversely proportional to molecular weight. Therefore, M1 should be greater than M2. Lighter molecules moves with faster rate at higher speed. So M2 is a lighter molecule. Therefore, it moves with faster speed. So let us do some problems. The average velocity of an ideal gas molecule at 27 degrees Celsius is given. The average velocity of same gas at 927 degrees Celsius. So velocity, so gas is same, first point. Therefore, molecular weight will be same. So what we know is C average is proportional to square root of temperature. Same gas, so molecular weight is same. So C1 by C2 equal to square root of T1 by T2. Let us assume C1 as the first 0.3 meters per second, T1 27 degrees Celsius, nothing but 300 Kelvin. C2 we have to find, T2 is 927 degrees Celsius, that is nothing but 1200 Kelvin. Substituting in the equation, 0.3 by C2 equal to 300 by 1200. So this is 1 by 4, square root of 1 by 4 is 2. C2 is 0.3 into 2, that is 0.6 meters per second. So your answer is option A. Coming to this kinetic energy per mole of ideal gas, nothing but average kinetic energy. Kinetic energy per mole is, average kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature. So answer is A. The RMS speed of a molecule in a gas at 20 degrees Celsius is to be increased by 1%. To what temperature must the gas be raised? So RMS speed of a gas molecule. So what we know is RMS speed equal to 3 RT by M. Here, this is per mole. We require per molecule. R equal to K into Na. K into Na. Boltzmann constant equal to R into Na. Whereas capital M equal to M into Na. This we have already studied. Boltzmann constant equal to R by Na. Molecular weight equal to, which is total mass of one mole of gas equal to mass of one molecule into Avogadro number. So what we can write here is, R by M
equal to K into Na by M into Na. What I will get is K by M. So this is equal to 3 kT by small m.
This is for molecule, this is per mole. That is the difference. From this equation, K is anyway constant, gas is constant.
So RMS velocity is proportional to square root of T, or U square is proportional to square root of T.
Right. Come back to the problem. So before increasing, let us assume U1. Before increasing, let us assume U1, temperature T1 is 20 degrees Celsius, 20 plus 273 is 293 Kelvin. After increasing, U2 is 1.01%, that is into 100 by 100 of initial one, that is U1, 1.01% of its initial one. T2 we have to find. So substituting here, what we get? U1 square by U2 square equal to T1 by T2. We'll get right. 3 km, right? No problem. So U1 plus 1.01 U1 equal to T1, 293 by T2. So T2 equal to 1.01 U1 by U1 into, sorry, this is the whole square. So T2 equal to 1.0201 U1 square by U1 square into 293. This is 1.0201 into 293. Approximately you will get 299 Kelvin. Approximately you can write it as 25.9 degree Celsius. Coming to the next problem, at what temperature SO2 gas has same velocity as that of oxygen at 127?
So SO2 gas molecular weight is 64, oxygen molecular weight 32. So M1, let us assume T1 we have to find, T2, M2, 127, that is 400 Kelvin.
Right. So what we know is
C1 by C2 equal to square root of T1, M1, T2, M2. C1 for SO2, C2 for oxygen.
At what temperature SO2 gas has same velocity? So it is given that C1 equal to C2. So what we get is T1, M1 equal to T2, M2. T1, we have to find. M1 64, T2 400, M2 32. So T1 equal to 64 by 32 into 400, that is 800 Kelvin.
ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యారంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.